Vessel. The example for convection is heating. Languages. Students, have you ever seen the sea? आपने कभी समुद्र देखा है? अधिकतर sea beaches पे क्या होता है कि रात के समय क्या होगा? Land जो होगी वो बहुत cool हो जाती है और दिन के समय sea जो होता है वो बहुत cool हो जाता है. So these two things will give a rise to land breeze and sea breeze. This is a natural phenomena, land breeze and sea breeze. So, students, first I am taking the land breeze. The land breeze arises in night. Keep in mind, land breeze arises in night. So, what will happen at night? At night, the water of sea become warmer as compared to land. The water of sea become warmer as compared to land, and what will happen? The warm air above the sea will rises up. We know very well the basic concept that the cool air comes down and warm air rises up. So what will happen? The warm air above the sea rises up and the cool air which is present on the land. The warm air above the sea rises up and the cool air which is present above the land will move towards the sea to take the place of warm air. So in this way, all the warm air rises up and the cool air flows from land to sea. This air rises from land and moves towards towards sea. That is why it is called as land breeze. Okay, this arises from the land, that is why it is called as land breeze. Land breeze means that during the night, when land becomes colder than the sea, then the cool air moves from land to sea. This process or this air is called as land breeze. Okay, so this is the natural phenomena and an example of convection. Okay, this also sets up a convection current. How? When warm air rises up and cool air will take the place of this warm air, and in this way there will be establishment of convection current, which is a most important consequence of land breeze. Okay. The previous process was land breeze, and another natural phenomena is sea breeze. Sea breeze occurs during the day. Land breeze occurs at night, and sea breeze occurs during the day. So, what will happen during the day? The land becomes hotter than the sea. That means the land becomes hotter as compared to the water of sea. What will happen during the night? During the night, the land become colder than sea, whereas during the day, the land become hotter than sea. So, what will happen during the day? The warm air which is present on the land will rise up. Due to the concept that warm air always rises up, and the cool air will move from sea to the land to take the place which is lived by warm air present on the land. So in this way, the warm air continuously rising up and the breeze moves from sea to land. The cool breeze moves from sea to land, and this process also continues to establish a convection current. So what is the basic difference between sea breeze and land breeze? Sea breeze occurs during the day, whereas the land breeze occurs during the night. This is the natural phenomena related to the process of convection. Now, there are some more consequences of convection from your daily life, which I am going to further explain. Like ventilation in your room. All of you are having a door or windows which are present in your room. So what is the function of these windows and doors? you will be able to understand with the help of concept of convection. This is called as ventilation in room. Ventilation, what will happen inside the room, the warm air which always rises up and moves the warm air being lighter. This is the warm air which is present inside the room. The warm air being lighter rises up and leaves the room through the ventilator provided near the ceiling. So many rooms are having some ventilators, some small ventilators, so which are prepared so that the warm air from these ventilators moves out and the fresh air will come inside the room by window or doors. So the warm air will move outside the room with the help of ventilators which are present on the ceiling, and the fresh air will always enter from the window or the doors which are present inside, in your room. So this is the process. That is why the ventilators are very important for a room, so that the fresh air inside the room can be maintained. The another consequence of convection is air conditioner. Students, during these summer days, I think most of you are using the air conditioner, and have you ever noticed that the split AC is always fitted at the top of a room? The split AC, especially I'm talking about the split AC, it is always fitted at a higher level on the wall of room. It is because the air conditioner, what is the function of air conditioner? It cools the air. The air will become cooler just because of this air conditioner. So warm air present inside the room will rises up, and the cool air from the air conditioner will comes down, and that is why the air conditioner is always fitted at the higher levels. Another example is room heater placed near the floor. It is just opposite to this concept, as with the help of a room heater or anything, it will produce a warm heat which will go above. That is why it is placed always near the floor. Some more examples are there, students, like freezer. Especially in refrigerator, you have seen the freezers are always placed at the top. This is also an example of convection. What will happen in the villages? In the villages, the people are using mud. लोग क्या करते हैं, मड और कीचड़ से अपने घरों को पोतते हैं. ये क्यों करते हैं? क्योंकि ये क्या करता है, एक कंडक्टर का काम करता है, जिससे कि घर की फ्रेश एयर जाड़ों में घर को ये गर्म रखते हैं और ठंडियों में गर्म. जाड़ों में ये गर्म रखते हैं और गर्मियों में ठंडा रखते हैं. तो ये भी एक एग्जाम्पल है कन्वेक्शन का. सो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट द प्रोसेस ऑफ कन्वेक्शन. Now in the next lecture, I will tell you about the process of radiation.